All right, guys, top seven answers are on the board. Name a place where the staff receive a lot of angry phone calls. Frankie.
Outrance. Call center. A call center.
Call center. Candace.
Cops.
The cops. Yeah. That was a good answer. Pass or play?
We're playing.
We're gonna play. Anele, how are you?
I'm good, Steve. How are you?
Good. So introduce the team.
Oh, this is Anele and the Club, the hottest, most fun breakfast show in Johannesburg. This is my co-host, Frankie.
Hi, Steve.
Ladies, he's married. Sorry, I know he's good looking, but he's married. And then this is
also... I wasn't actually thinking that at all. When you went to him, I didn't think, man, that's a good looking guy.
Did you not see Leonardo DiCaprio right now?
No, I didn't hit him.
Are you sure?
Ben Affleck?
Ben Affleck. Yes. Oh, that's him. Doggone it, Anele. You better stop playing.
Okay, can we move on from Ben Affleck?
Absolutely.
Okay, then we've got Sandra Bullock, but she's also called... This is Cindy.
Hello, Cindy.
She's our sports reader.
All right.
And then our news reader is Thembekile Mkgothotho.
And I'm not married.
His name is what?
Thembekile, take over.
Thembekile. Do you want to take it up a notch and throw in the surname?
Yes!
It gets better.
Go ahead.
Mkgothotho.
My
now
man.
Say, Thembekile Mkgothotho.
Thembekile Mkgothotho. Thembekile Mkgothotho. What? How long did it take you to spell that when you were growing up?
Only 29 years.
That's good. Who else we got?
And then that is the troll of the group. He is our producer, and he's the one who pranks everyone. His name is Ryan. Ryan, say what's up.
How do you do? Yeah.
What's up, Ryan? Now, this is... You're a Breakfast Club show, too. Morning Drive.
Yeah.
You're Morning Drive.
Yes, sir.
I'm Morning Drive. So this is really Family Feud for real. Yeah. Y'all not only feuding on the show, y'all actually going at it in real life.
Yeah.
Wow. Have you all ever met face to face before?
Yes, I've met Ankle Tap before. I've interviewed him on my very successful talk show.
Yeah. Wait a minute, Anele, you have a talk show.
I do indeed.
And you interviewed Ankle Tap.
Yes, I love him.
Oh, that's really good.
She loves me.
I do love him. I really love you.
Love you too, Anele.
My morning show, Steve Harvey Morning Show, I'm on in 112 cities, 9 million people every morning. My competitor is my dear friend, another comedian, Ricky Smiley.
Yes.
And the afternoon drive is the other kings of comedy, D.L. Hughley. He does National Afternoon Drive, I do National Morning Drive, and Ricky is the other competitor of mine, and all of us are in the same fraternity.
Ah, oh, that's beautiful.
It's very good.
That's beautiful.
I love radio, man. Oh, what charity are you playing for?
I've changed my name legally to Charity, so I'll be playing for myself.
That's a good one. I like that one. I like it.
Pores are us. We just feel that animals don't get as much attention as other people do. You know, the elderly, there's kids, but animals can't speak for themselves. So we've got a very a good relationship with Pores are Us from Midrand, and we support them.
Okay, great. All right, that's good. All right, so Cindy, how are you?
Somewhat nervous, but great.
Well, it's okay. TV, well, you know, you have a TV show, right? Talk show? So TV is a little bit different than radio.
Yeah.
They can see you.
Yep.
Here's what I like about television. On radio, you have all these DJs who say stuff that they think is absolutely hysterical. And they imagine thousands of people driving in their car cracking up laughing. And then when they come live and they say something funny and nobody laughs, I'll be laughing my ass off. That's what I like. Cindy, let's play. Name a place where the staff receive a lot of angry phone calls.
I would say delivery service.
Delivery service. My man, let me give it a shot. Timbekile. I'm telling you, I'm so much better at this than last season. Last season, it was horrible. Horrible. We would spend half the day me just trying to say these names. This year is a little bit better. All right, let's go, man. Name a place where the staff receive a lot of angry phone calls.
Hotel.
The hotels. Ryan, how you doing, man?
Good in here.
Good, good, good. Now, listen to me, Ryan. We got two strikes. YFM can steal. Ryan, name a place where the staff receive a lot of angry phone calls.
Eskom.
What'd you say? Eskom.
They supply the power, or the lack of power.
Oh. Eskom. Oh, the load-shedding people.
Yes, yes.
I wouldn't even work there. I wouldn't, every time the phone rang, I'd just go to sleep. I'm not that. Eskom. In L.A., we got two strikes, darling. We got to be careful. YFM can steal. Give me a place where the staff receive lots of angry phone calls.
I would say, like, an airport, like an airline. Which, can I just say airline?
Well...
No? Yes?
Well, I mean, right now, y'all ain't got nobody to call, do you? Can you call anybody?
Can I, should I keep that answer, or should I change it?
No, you gotta keep the answer. That's the one we gotta go to. I just found out 2 days ago I can't even fly out of here.
Never leaving us.
Y'all a trip, man. Y'all fly us in, but we can't fly back out. Oh, you'll take us, but won't nobody take y'all. Y'all will let everybody come in, but y'all try to fly out of here, they go, no, 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 no. Airlines. All right, guys, let's go. Give me a place where the staff receive a lot of angry phone calls.
The bank.
The bank. Number seven. Six.
Oh.
Four. One.
Cell phone provider. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I said that T real quiet that time. Oh.
Soft.
One more time. Ha. I'm just gonna call you Hobo. Ain't no damn tea. How about that? All right, guys, let's go. In this round, we've doubled the points. We've surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
Chewing gum.
Chewing gum.
Oh.
Well, pass or play.
We're gonna play.
Let's play.
Okay. It's okay, Cindy. You didn't want to answer that. That's fine. Thank you. She didn't even try to hit the buzzer. Cindy just
yeah.
went,
Yeah, my brain.
I'm not saying a damn thing.
My husband's watching, so.
Yeah, I noticed that. Great.
What? Can I go back? It's the look of shame.
Nsiko. Nsako.
There you go.
I got it. Nsako. Name something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
Mouthwash.
My man, mouthwash. Josie, name something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
Toothpaste.
Toothpaste. DJ Ankle Tap, come on, man, give me something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
A stock sweet or a sucker. A lollipop.
Oh. What did you say at first?
So it's a sweet that's on the end of a stick or a stalk. So stalk sweets. But a lollipop.
Stalk sweet.
Yeah.
Stalk.
Stalk sweets, yeah.
So like a stalk and a sweet.
Yeah.
Stalk sweet.
Yeah, boom.
Stalk sweet. Candace.
Yes, Mr. Harvey.
Name something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
Whew, a thumb.
A thumb?
A thumb. People suck their thumbs, right?
I don't.
They suck other things. Thumbs, sorry, thumbs, thumbs, thumbs. Let's keep it at thumbs. Sorry.
I hope that's not on the board.
My number one goal in life is to go to heaven. I am not listening to her. Them other things that's in your mouth is none of my damn business. Let's see if thumb is up there. Thumb!
Oh, no!
Only one strike, my man. Name something you put in your mouth, but do not swallow.
A straw.
A straw! Oh, we got two strikes now. Little brother, we got to be careful, man. 947 can steal. They gonna get on this board, man. Okay, name something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
A toothbrush.
A toothbrush! Hey, look, we all radio people, so this is just a suggestion. You don't have to listen to me. If I were you, I would get this one.
Yeah.
Just a suggestion. Just want to make it look a little bit more competitive, because it's starting to feel some kind of way about itself. You know what I mean? And this is the battle of the morning drive shows. You are the people that wake them up in the morning. Yeah. They have to make a decision how they're going to start their day.
Hallelujah, Steve.
People only invite you inside of their homes and automobiles if they love you. Yeah. You don't invite nobody in your house you don't like. Yeah. So when they tune in to you, it's because they feel a certain way about you. Now, let's get this thing a little more even here. Yes, I'm putting pressure on you. I'm trying to make you sweat. Give me something you put in your mouth but do not swallow.
A toothpick.
A toothpick! Number six.
What's the papa action? A gun.
A 4-5, Vanille.
Oh!
Number five.
Oh,